that I've observed with Jordan that he isn't a genius at, and I don't even know if you recognize how much of a genius you are at it, but the idea of coming up with a simple daily method of operation for an organization that you can follow and you can teach, mm-hmm. other people can follow and they can teach,
right.
has probably, would you say that's been the secret?
Absolutely.
To your success?
Yeah. In my mind, because I'm very, very simple person, and in my mind, I can take a concept and break it down into a simple three steps or a simple explanation that will allow people not just to get it, but be able to communicate it to others. And I believe that when somebody says, I can do this, then they want to do it, and they sign up.
Right.
And then if they can explain it to someone else such that that person can say, I can do this, then that individual wants to sign up. I always like to apply what I call the 8-year-old test. And the 8-year-old test is if an 8-year-old can do it and an 8-year-old can teach it now, then you should do it.
Hmm.
If an 8-year-old can't do it and an 8-year-old can't teach it now, then you probably shouldn't do it, because it may be really good for you, but it probably won't communicate through your organization.
Right.
So when I meet with somebody, when I lay something out for them or I'm explaining something to them, I want them to go, you know what? This looks good and I can do it.
Hmm.
And then they go, I want to do it. Because it's great if they look at it and they go, wow, this looks really good, but I'm not really sure if I can do it.
Right.
You know, if the person that's communicating isn't communicated in such a way that they go, wow, you're really smart, well, that's probably not going to duplicate too well.
Right.
And there are systems out there that are really, really good. If you're good in sales, so you're excellent at sales and you can close anyone, well, that's great. You'll sign up a lot of people. But the people you sign up, they won't be able to close everyone because they don't see themselves as salespeople.
Right.
But if somebody looks at it and goes, this is pretty simple. I can see this. I can see me explaining it to someone else. Then they're going to say, yeah, I want to sign up for that.
So in anybody's company, what you'd recommend is that they come up with a simple daily method of operation of one, two, or three things that everybody in the organization kind of agrees is, this is our baseline, this is what we'll do. You know, every day when I wake up in the morning, before I go to sleep at that night, I'm going to do these one or two or three things. I'm going to stay consistent. The other thing that I think is fascinating about you, and it's a really good attribute of yours that more people should have, is consistency.
Mm-hmm.
Consistency. Some people will, you know, they'll get off to a good start and then they won't stay consistent.
Yeah.
You've consistently recruited 1 to 4 people a month.
Yep. Signed up about 235 people in the past 7 years. I don't know what that comes out to, but it's probably about 3 a month.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, and that's just consistent. This month, will it be the
same
thing?
Just every day, fill your pipeline with someone new, a couple new people. Meet however you meet people. You know, whether it's you like going to sporting events, or you go to your parent-teacher association meetings, or you like doing the networking clubs, or maybe you're on Facebook a lot. However you do it, just have a plan to meet new people all the time. Right. And then get to know those people. And those people become part of your sphere of influence and your contacts, and you kind of constantly advance those relationships.
Out of those 235. Out of 235 people, how many of those did you know prior to getting involved 7 years ago?
Probably about 20.
20.
About 10%.
So 215 you just met.
Yeah, over time. And actually, I've shown my business now to about 2,000 people.
Right.
And from those 2,000, I've got my 235 distributors. So that means that there's, I don't know how, 1,800 people that didn't sign up.
Or said they were going to and
or
didn't.
Or said they were going to, and they still say they're going to.
Yeah,
some
exactly.
Of them. Some of them went away. Some of them, I lost their contact information. They changed it. They moved.
Right.
Yeah.
Interesting.
But most people tend to focus on the 1,800 that didn't do it.
Yeah.
Instead of focusing on the 200 that did. Or it might be a case of you focus on the 15 you showed it to that didn't do it instead of the one that you signed up.
Right.
And then even after you start signing people up, we were having this conversation last night with a group of people down by the fire by the beach. You know, when you've got a group, let's say you've signed up 15 people in your company. Well, it's really easy to get caught up. Well, I do it too. We all do. We get caught up in the people that aren't doing anything, mm-hmm. versus the people that are. It's like working, you want to work with the people that don't need your help versus trying to help the people that need your help, because the people that need your help typically aren't going to do anything.
Let them ask.
Yeah, right. Yeah, yeah.